for this chapter, like I told you already, preparation methods are not important. All the named reactions are important. Write on next. Hard ester reaction. And ester reaction. Write down. By this reaction, an acid converts into another acid with one more carbon atom. Write down, in this reaction, acid chloride treated with diazomethane and forms diazoketone which goes under rearrangement and forms ketene which reacts with silver oxide in presence of H2O and gives higher acid okay. Reaction, you see here, we use acid derivative generally into this. RCOOH, if it is allowed to react with SOCl2, it forms acyl chloride, RCOCl, acyl chloride. Now this acyl chloride is further allowed to react with 2 moles of diazomethane. This is diazomethane, right? 2 hydrogen replaced by N2, diazomethane we have here. This H and this Cl forms HCl and it gives CH double bond, C double bond O, CH N2. This is diazoketone, right? This is diazoketone. When you heat this and it goes under rearrangement and it forms RCH double bond C double bond O, this is ketene. This ketene with silver or silver oxide we can also take with H2O. It converts into RCH2COOH. This is the acid we get here. Overall reaction, if you see, RCOOH converts into what? RCH2COOH. So one methylene group you have to insert between the alkyl group and COOH. Okay. The mechanism you see after this, diazoketone is this, RC double bond O, CH double bond N, positive charge on this nitrogen and negative charge. Okay, this is diazoketone, this one. When you heat this, so in this reaction also, with this ketene, N2 also goes out. Nitrogen gas evolves into this. This electron comes over here, right? And this bond pair of electrons shift onto this carbon atom so that this bond breaks and N2 goes out in the reaction mixture. So it forms RC double bond O, CH with one lone pair, negative charge on it, plus we'll get N2 gas. Okay. This is actually a carbene intermediate, this one. Carbene intermediate, right? Now in this, whenever this carbene intermediate forms adjacent to the carbonyl group, and this is true for nitrines also, that we'll see in amines chapter, okay? Whenever this amines or nitrines or carbenes intermediate forms adjacent to this carbonyl group, there's a rearrangement takes place. Okay, so R plus rearrange itself here. Rearrangement takes place, and this rearrangement we call it as Wolf rearrangement. Right. This comes over here, this electron pair goes here, and it forms RCH, double bond C, double bond, right, which on reaction with H2O, with AG, converts into RCH2CO, right? So basically H plus comes over here, and this takes OH minus, RCH2CO. Okay, one very important point here is, this H2O, I'll write down this way. If you take this H2O, then you'll get acid here. So this H is coming from this H2O. Right? If you take ROH here, then the product will be RCH2COOR. So this is coming from this solvent that you are taking in the last, that you'll get ester. This one you write down properly. Right. So we are getting acid which has one carbon more here, RCH2CH, one CH2 we have to introduce. If you are not taking H2O in the last step, you won't get acid. Alcohol if you take, you'll get ester, okay, RCO. This is it, preparation, we have only few methods. There are few important name of this compound we have, which we should know. CH2N and COOH. Okay. Right. Now when N is equals to 0, the molecular formula is what? And this we call it as oxalic acid. This name you must remember. N is equals to 0, the molecule is oxalic acid. Similarly, N is equals to 1, it is malonic acid. N is equals to 2, we call it as succinic acid. N is equals to 3, glutaric acid. N is equals to 4, which is adipic acid. N is equals to 5, we call it as pimelic acid. So how do you memorize this? You need to keep this in mind. Three structure of the formula you must remember. What is this compound? PHCH double bond CH COOH. Phenolic. It's not phenolic. When it here reaction, cinnamic acid. Cinnamic acid, okay? PH को अगर मैं CH3 से replace कर दूं, then this one is protonic acid. Lactic acid, what is the formula? CH3COH, it is lactic acid. These two are GI of each other, right? Cis and trans?
Yes.
Right. The cis one is malic acid. And this one is fumaric. So, ye sare naam yaad rakhna. Structure bhi yaad. This is it, carboxylic acid.
Reaction?
Reaction kar liya.
That was preparation.
Hmm?
That was preparation.
Reaction last plus, yeah. There are some name reactions we have, that is Hoffman, bromide, Curtius, that will do in amines. So amines will. Because for that, the intermediates are nitrines. So first we'll see what is nitrines, and then we'll see the reactions of amines. Okay? There are a few more name reactions we have in this chapter, that we'll discuss in the amines chapter. First we'll see intermediate nitrines, and then we'll discuss that. What is? Etard reaction. Yeah, we have that reaction also.
We finished it. When?
It's afternoon.
I haven't done it. Write down. It's that again name reaction we have. Write down in this reaction. In this reaction, the methyl group. CrO2Cl2. In this reaction, the methyl group, which is attached to an aromatic ring, generates this benzene ring. It's an aromatic compound reaction here. Attached to aromatic ring, converts into aldehyde functional group. Converts into aldehyde functional group when it is heated in presence of an oxidizing agent which is generally chromyl fluoride, CrO2Cl2, right? Solvent, we can use inert solvent like CCl4, we can use chloroform also, we can use for this purpose. Right. So the reaction is, suppose we have a ring with CH3 attached here, and when it is heated with CrO2Cl2, chromyl chloride, with CCl4 as a solvent, forms C double bond O and H. This is the reaction here. We'll get some oxides of chromium also into this. And then some HCl also will get into this reaction. Okay. This is also direct name reaction we have. Reactions of aromatic compounds. Aromatic compound.
So mechanism?
Mechanism is not there. See, actually, aisa kuch hoga. CrO2Cl2 and
CrO2HCl2 twice with CH. That's the intermediate form in H plus. Yes.
How do we get this? We have CrO2Cl2 and this is an oxidizing agent, right?
So react with H2O. So the
reacts with
H2. So
this one.
From there, H2. So
we're going
CrO. So
you're saying
CH
this.
In brackets, Cr. CH in brackets, Cr. O. 2. H. Cl. HCl2 and then twice.
Like this?
Yeah. So it actually reacts with 2CrO2Cl2.
You get this,
yeah.
Is it?
This is the intermediate.
And then?
And then CHO after the reaction with H plus.
What's missing the terms?
So this one. Yeah, CHO.
Mechanism with you. OCRO HCl2. Which I'm trying to try
with H3O plus.
HLS is 2. CHO.
Twice.
We take two molecules of this, no?
Yeah, two
molecules. So, this is the hydrogen.
Two hydrogens.
Two hydrogen. This hydrogen is the hydrogen.
It's because
you
have some
So, this is it. And then, this reaction is H plus.
So the
a
double
bond will
move, and then you have an OH.
So this H.
Oh, you have OH.
What
did I just say? I don't know what I'm saying.
Just say.
I don't know. Stop.
ऐसा कुछ होगा. This H plus will go onto this oxygen. ठीक है?
And then you get.
We have a positive ion. ठीक है? Or we have ring here. Or this molecule is nothing but this. So with H plus, this comes over here, and this bond breaks, right? So we'll get what?
So correct only 2H. OH will come on same carbon and then.
And we have one more molecule this one.
Yeah, so you have 2OH.
So we have this, and the same thing will happen here. CR double bond O, H, CL and CL as I over. Both are positive charge. So finally this two goes out when this bond breaks, right? And we get this COH, OH and H. And then if we hit karoge isko, to H2 nikal jayega yahan se. H2 nikal jayega, CO2 aa jayega. Mechanism, पता नहीं मैंने देखा नहीं है इसका ऐसा नहीं कुछ होगा. How we get this? इसके बाद तो चलो ये ठीक है. But how do we get this? After this, did you understand? This two molecule we have. So with H plus H2O, this oxygen, this oxygen gets protonated. Positive charge here. Then this bond goes here, this two molecules goes out, take this OH minus from the solvent. Correct? And when we get this OH here, when you heat this H2O molecule goes out, we'll get aldehyde here. So that's what the product we have, CHO. Okay? So after this, fine. But how do we get this?
So because Cr will have a double bond with both the O's, right?
You're saying this double bond O.
And CNCl. So one double R bond will break and attach the O.
Right.
And
so
one
we have
double
Cl and CH. So we have two molecules. So one of two hydrogen, one of this hydrogen comes over here. We'll get single bond, and then again another molecule will have this.
Yeah, and the other O will attach to the C.
Huh, and then this will attach to this. I'm just saying more mechanism. Okay, but again, mechanism is not important in this. This methyl group basically converts into CHO. We are using bromyl chloride oxidizing agent in an inert solvent CCl4, carbon tetrachloride, carbon disulfide also we can use here. And then the next step we use H plus H2O. Gives you benzaldehyde, okay? CHO. Okay, so next class we'll start amines. Thank you. Let me show the attendance.